Hey everyone, and welcome to another All About RVs video. Today we're going to take a real quick look at a brand new 2023 Sierra Luxury 388 BHRD fifth wheel. As you can see on the floor plan, this is a two bedroom, bath and a half unit. We're going to take a few minutes, walk you through the inside and outside of the RV, kind of show you what it's all about. We'll be right back on the inside. All right, we are up inside the brand new 2023 Sierra 388. We're going to take a few minutes to walk you around the inside and outside here. So let's start back here in the back section, then we'll kind of work our way forward. So we're going to step up into the bunk area. And on our right-hand side here, we have one of our slide outs. This is a sofa during the day and a bed at night. There is a flip down bunk just above it. We'll flip that down and show you what it looks like here in a second. TV hookups along the back wall there, some drawer space and cabinet space for hanging closet. Over on this side, we have some more drawer space down on the bottom and two more bunks. And on the left side right here, we have a little half bath area. So you got a vent fan up above, medicine cabinet, a window in here, sink with hot and cold water, and a porcelain foot flush toilet. And there is also an AC duct in there as well. But a lot of room back here. All vinyl floor on your main subfloor, a little bit of carpet on the slide out floor section. Has little latches here to hold the upper bunk up out of the way. So you gotta undo the little latches. And it drops down. Now there is actually a mattress that goes there. It's over on the other bunk over here. And then you can also drop down the bed here. We're gonna set the camera down here real quick just to kind of show you what this looks like as well. There's a little latch you put right here. Allows this to slide out. Drops down into place. So pretty simple and easy to do. There's even some USB charger ports and an electric outlet on the end here as well. Couple electric outlets on those walls over there, some shelf space over there as well. So nice big kids room, you sleep four or five kids back here pretty comfortably. And we're step on back down into our living room kitchen area here. So over here we have a large slide out, some nice big windows in this slide as well. It's kind of set up to have the freestanding chairs with the table that is mounted to the wall. Tri-fold sofa over here, so this will flip out and make into a bed. You could sleep an extra guest or two on here. Now when this is out, it comes right up against the island, so there's not really much room to walk around that side. However, you can still walk behind the island where I'm standing. You have theater seat over there, does have the little light up cup holders and LED light below. Quite a bit of overhead cabinet space up there. And even some above your sofa as well. Pretty large ceiling fan. You can also see the Coleman ducted AC up there as well. There's a couple speakers in the roof. Got a little wall clock above the door there. On the side of the island here, you have your propane leak detector, electric outlet, and a little light switch for the tow kick lighting as well. Large LG refrigerator here, so you got freezer on bottom, refrigerator part on top. The real big Insignia oven, glass front, does have the light in it as well. And you also have the little lights above your knobs. Four burner gas stove top as well. Large LG microwave. Some space above there for storage. And then we have kind of a pantry area over here. And there are drawers down here. Now, one thing I forget to mention sometimes on these videos for the Sierra product, on the Luxury Edition, it has the tire pressure monitoring system as well. And there's also a water filtration system built in too. But full extending ball bearing drawer guide of drawers. Quite a bit of storage space here around your TV area. Electric fireplace, which is basically a fancy electric space heater. And you have some storage above, sound bar. So you got a Kinect sound bar and a Kinect TV as well. And over here, quite a bit more storage space. You have soft close hinges on your doors as well, which is really nice. High rise sprayer faucet, some more drawer space and storage space under your island as well. Now, one thing I probably would recommend is some little flip up countertop extensions. For whatever reason, they don't do those currently on this model, but you could do them aftermarket. So that would be something I would definitely recommend for this. Other than that, it's got a lot of stuff built in, pretty much standard, that I think you'll really love. Spinning on around here again, we are going toward the main bathroom, bedroom area. So you have your little entry door, exit door, traditional screen door and everything there. Grab handle to get you up and down the steps. Electric box with the breakers and fuses down here. A little bit of step lighting down there. There are controls for your on-demand water heater. They're currently using the Furrion on-demand water heater. And we have ceiling fan controls here. Central vac right over there. Pretty large window here in your hallway. No, it does not open, but it does let in a lot of natural light. And bathroom right here on the left. So you got some storage space here. A fan up top, AC duct in here, skylight above, ABS tub surround with a sit-down seat, glassed-in enclosure, foot-flush porcelain toilet, some more storage below, and it does have one of those adjustable shower bars as well. On into your master bedroom area here. So we have another slide out here and window on each side of the bed. Does have some little accent lighting in here as well. This is a camper queen bed. The bed will raise up, so there's a little storage underneath of that as well, but it will not accept a king. The slide out is not big enough to accept a king. There's electric outlet, USB charger ports down there, some little shelf space over there as well. Looking up at the ceiling area here, you have a second 15,000 BTU Coleman ducted AC. There's plenty of room to maneuver around the bed area here as well. And slide this open here so you can kind of see back in here your closet area. So some shelf space back in there, hanging closet rod across the top section here. Part of the King Wi-Fi setup if you want to use that to help connect into a campground's Wi-Fi. Now this one is equipped with the washer dryer as well. So we'll slide this open so you can kind of see this too. This is the Splendide stackable washer dryer. And you got a couple little lights in there that you turn on and off by a little push button. Now, if you don't do the washer dryer stackable, you'll have more closet rod across the top there. So you could hang some more clothes there. four drawers, little dresser area there, electric outlet on the side of the dresser. There is a backer in the wall, so you could mount your TV there if you want. And on the ceiling up there, cable outlets along with electric outlet to do the TV. Now just remember, if you are putting a TV on this wall, the wall is only roughly 2 inches thick. Do not use a screw that is too long. You'll go right through the side. Not good to do. And then you have a large window here in your bedroom that does open. Pretty nice crown molding and stuff running down the ceiling area. All right, now outside, I want to show you around the outside here real quick, show you what it's all about. We'll be right back on the outside. All right, we're back on the outside of the brand new 2023 Sierra Luxury 388 BHRD model here. Gonna start here on the door side. We'll kind of spin our way around. So first things up, we have kind of a light grayish color fiberglass exterior, aluminum studded foam block insulated sidewalls with a lower black metal skirting and some vinyl graphics. Power awning, LED light strip built in close to the body of the RV, manual override in the front arm head in case of an electronic failure, and you also have adjustable arms for tilting. There's two outdoor speakers down low. You have two 30-pound propane tanks on a slide-out tray that'll slide out when you need to fill them up. You have a very large pass-through storage compartment. The unit has what they call a drop Z frame, giving you taller, higher storage here compared to a traditional straight frame. Spare tire is in here, out of the way, kind of an out of sight, out of mind thing. A thief or somebody might actually try to steal it if it's on the bottom. They're less likely to see that, obviously being in here. And it's also out of the weather. Then you do have a electric outlet and cable outlet out here as well. Just kind of looking down below here. Front auto level jack system here. This is a 6-point hydraulic automatic leveling jack system. So you have two jacks in the front, two just in front of your axles, and then two just behind your axles. Again, they're using the hydraulic version. The hydraulic version is a little bit faster, it's stronger and a little more reliable than the electric version. When you get into a really large coach like this, the hydraulic is the better route to go. You do have the More Ride entrance step here. It's rated for 500 pounds, adjustable feet. Flips up inside the doorway when you're traveling. And their More Ride step that they use here has the shock assist on it, so it's really nice and easy to flip into the doorway. There's an electric outlet below that speaker there, along with a cold water spray port there as well. Large folding entry handle to help you get in and out of the RV. And then it is prepped for what they call a 4-camera system. So just above the entry door, you have that little porch light there. And then just to the right of that, you also have that prepping for the 4-camera system. So you could have a camera above your entry door. And then there's also prepping on the back, you'll see when we get back there. And then they prep it to have a camera on each side. So again, nice safety feature to consider adding if you're buying a Sierra like this. Being able to see all the way around this thing when you're traveling down the road or backing into a campsite. On the side of the slide out up there, that little black rectangle is your stove exhaust vent. The unit is a double axle unit. It does have a tire pressure monitoring system on it. That's a very nice feature on the RV for safety. It has drum brakes, aluminum wheels, and currently riding on Goodyear Endurance tires. Now just behind the rear stabilizer jack is an LP quick disconnect, so if you wanted to plug in a portable grill out here, you could do so. Quite a bit of storage on the back. Now this was the section we stepped up into when we were going into the kids' bunk room. You can see some of that aluminum tube framing and stuff up there as well on part of the construction. They put the little shock struts on these doors here so they can't go up too far and get caught into your slide out. Now this is a really cool feature. This is the MoreRide slide tray. This slide tray is rated for 800 pounds and it has a little release handle here to allow you to slide it in or out. Now very, very important when you're doing this here to just kind of watch your fingers and stuff when you're sliding things in so you don't accidentally pinch something. You got these little cargo nets around here as well. Now the back door is held up by magnetic catches when you flip it up like I have it here. And it has slam locks on it as well. Traditional flat back fiberglass rear end. Now you do have, again, the prepping on the back for that rear camera, but also to the right there is prepping for the Lippert portable stow and go ladder. That is an aftermarket ladder you can buy. It's rated for, I think, about 330 pounds, if I remember right, but it telescopes down, allowing you to climb up and down on and off the roof. And then when you're done using it, you just throw it in the storage compartment and you don't have to worry about the kids or the neighbor's kids or somebody climbing up on your roof, damaging something or falling off and getting hurt. Now they also put electric outlets in here as well. I forgot to mention that on the other side as well. But there's two electric outlets, one on each side, and then there's those LED light strips you can see there as well. Let's kind of step back here so you can see down the whole side. A really nice setup. Deep tent safety glass windows. They do have an option for dual pane windows if you're going to be an extended stay type of customer. Right here, there are a little gate valve area down here. Behind that little round thing is where you would actually reach in to open one of your gate valves. But you could see your little dump area right here. And that's for the rear half bath area. Detachable power cord, roughly about 30, 35 feet long, somewhere in that range. Again, 50 amp electric service for this unit. Now you're gonna have a second dump area just up here. And those handles will be in the docking station. Now right there is hot and cold low point water drains for winterization. Furrion on-demand water heater, furnace exhaust out here. We have the whole house water filtration system, black tank flush area here. Another black tank flush down there because you have bath and a half. City water slash freshwater fill up here. So you hook your hose up and then you turn these valves in the right direction to send the water where it's supposed to go. Cable satellite inlets, hot and cold outside utility shower, black and gray handles here as well. There's a light in here and the cap light switch as well. The other side of our storage area here, we have battery disconnect, another motion light here, and then you have your 30 amp solar charge controller right here. The unit does come with a solar panel on the roof. The freshwater tank drain is located just down below here. Inch and a half gate valve, so it will drain out a lot faster. Nice, thick, heavy-duty baggage door here, so better insulation. Slam lock baggage door. Here's battery compartment area here, inverter, and auto level jack controls. This gets you on and off the truck along with auto leveling the RV as well. Right here is some very important informational stickers as far as dry weights, gross weights. This thing has a dry weight of 13,828 pounds. Has a gross weight, it says, of 15,904 pounds. There's also your tire sticker right there. And again, production date, VIN numbers, all that type of stuff on those stickers. On the front of the RV, you have a really nice fiberglass front shell. So heavy duty front cap. There is a little bit of paint on this part as well, and then obviously vinyl decals too. The unit has the Rhino pin box. So if you're gonna buy an aftermarket pin box, like say a Curt Air Ride or a MoreRide pen box or whatever, you do have to make sure it bolts up to the Rhino pen box pattern. You have your breakaway cable here, 7-way Barkman wiring plug, and then you have an LED light strip up here for nighttime hookup. Light switch there, and then again, more storage down here. And back in behind there is where you can kind of access some of the guts of the RV, that little removable panel there. But overall, pretty cool large bunkhouse family RV here. Thanks again, guys, for taking the time to watch my RV videos. Really do appreciate it. Please be sure to check out the folks at Couches RV Nation, one of the largest internet discount dealers in the country. And also, please remember to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks again.